What's up, you guys, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Danielle. I am a licensed hairstylist, and I post a lot of days in my life, weeks in my life, salon vlogs, and hairdresser videos like this one. So make sure to subscribe, follow me on all of my social medias, and also make sure to hit that post notification bell to get notified of any time I post a new video. But guys, I can't believe I'm saying this, but I have been a hairstylist for a year. A year. Like, what? I feel like I just started a few months ago. It's just unreal. But for this whole year, I've been so excited to film this video for you guys, just recapping how my first year of being a hairstylist went, what I've learned. I'm gonna talk to you all about income, how much money I make, pros and cons, client experiences, how to grow your clientele. I'm literally gonna talk about everything. But first, I wanted to give a little background story about where it all started. So cosmetology school actually wasn't my first idea or plan, I guess you can say. I did go to college before cosmetology school. I didn't finish, but I tried college. I went to college for a year and a half for x-ray tech, ultrasound tech, and just medical imaging in general, and I absolutely hated it. It was the worst year and a half of my life. I did a whole video about like why I dropped out and everything, so I will put that video up here for you guys if you guys want to go check that out. But yes, cosmetology school was always something I wanted to do, but I felt as if I needed to do some sort of college first to see if I liked it, see how it would go, and it was awful, which I knew was gonna happen. So after the year and a half, I went to cosmetology school. I went to Tony and Guy Hairdressing Academy. My time was a little bit different there though, because I started February of 2020 and March 2020 was when COVID and everything happened. So February was my first month at school, and then from March through June, I was on Zoom, which really sucked. And then from June to October, I was at the school finishing my program. I did do the full-time program just to get it over with as fast as I could. It was a quick 9-month program, and I didn't really miss much school, so I didn't have to make any time up. So it was very fast, February through October, and I was done. I also did another video on my entire cosmetology school experience, so if you want to check that out as well, I will also have that up here for you guys to check out. But yeah, so that's pretty much where it all began. So 3 weeks before I graduated, I needed to make sure that I had a job for when I graduated. Not everyone else had this mindset, but I did. For some reason, I just felt like if I waited until I graduated, it would have made me unmotivated and lazy because I'd finish school and have nothing to do, and then I'd have to stay at home until I found a job. And I didn't want to be like that at all. So I was like, I am going to make sure I have a job before I graduate. And that I did. 3 weeks before I graduated, I interviewed 2 salons. I know that might sound a little weird to you guys that I only interviewed at 2 salons, but the one that I currently work at right now was my dream. Like, it was where I wanted to work. I knew I wanted to work there, but I knew that I also needed to try somewhere else just in case something didn't work out. But thankfully, the dream salon that I've always wanted to work at hired me. The interview went so well, and I was able to get the job there before I even graduated. And something that was amazing about the salon I work at is that I was able to do hair as soon as I graduated. I know so many salons have their own rules, regulations of how they want to run their business, as far as you need to assist before doing anything, you need to shadow before doing any hair, you need to be like a receptionist first. I know so many salons that do that, but thankfully my salon that I work at was kind enough to understand that I knew that I was ready and let me do hair straight out of hair school. I didn't have to assist, I didn't have to shadow, I didn't have to do anything. The first week I finished school, I was doing hair in the salon. Now, I know that sometimes people feel like they're not ready when they first get out of hair school, and that is totally fine. If you are someone like that, I would 100% look for salons around your area that will let you assist first or even shadow, because you'll get so much experience doing that, and I feel like it'll make you more comfortable. But in my case, I think just because I took so many clients in hair school, I was just like, I feel ready, I feel confident, and my mindset was kind of like, you need to start somewhere, sometime, so why not just do it straight out of hair school? Because again, my mindset was that if I waited and did like assisting or receptionist or shadowing, it would make me feel discouraged and unmotivated and lazy, because I like to just do my own thing. But everyone's different, so if you do feel like you need to assist, 100% look for salons that do that. Another thing, I always get a lot of questions about if I was ever nervous to be on my own right away. Honestly, I feel like the first week of work was a little bit nerve-wracking, because you're just not used to not having your teachers, you know what I mean? But my coworkers and everyone that I work with were amazing when I first started, because anytime I needed a question, I knew I could go to any one of my coworkers, ask, and they will give me so much good information. So once I knew I had people like that to help me, I wasn't nervous after that. But definitely the first week of work was very nerve-wracking. So now I want to kind of talk about income and how much I've made within the year, because I know a lot of people really want to know this and ask me about this. But you have to keep in mind that from October, when I started, to January, COVID was still a really big issue. And when I first started, I missed at least a month of work, not all at once, but like spread out, because my mom had gotten COVID, so I needed to be out for 2 weeks. I had COVID, so I had to be out for 2 weeks, and it was just a lot of chaos when I first started, so that interfered with my pay as well. But yes, just want to let you guys know that, because not everyone's experience will be the same due to COVID. But the way my salon works is, when you first start out, you are considered hourly slash commission. So when you start your first salon job taking clients, you are not going to have this huge clientele with full booked weeks, like 5 clients a day. It's just not going to be like that. And if it is, that's amazing, because for the most part, it's never like that. It wasn't like that for me. So what my boss did was, each week, if I made more than I would hourly, I would make commission. But if I made less in commission and would be able to make more hourly, she'd give me hourly pay. And I want to say the rate was like $12 an hour. So for the first like 3-4 weeks, I made hourly because I didn't have a ton of clients. I did have clients, just not a ton. So I wasn't able to hit the mark of commission that was more than hourly, so she gave me hourly. But then after about 4 weeks, pay was like hourly, commission, commission, hourly. Like, it kind of went back and forth, because some of the weeks started to progress and get better, and I was getting more clients. So the better weeks I would make commission, and then the slower weeks again I'd make hourly. So it was kind of up and down. But then once like February hit, I have been making commission ever since. I haven't made hourly since February. And obviously January is the year of like W-2s, pay stubs, stuff like that. But literally went on to my website where my pay is, to be accurate with you guys. But since I started in October, obviously October to January, I had to do like a W-2. So just to give you guys an estimate for like when you're first starting out, from my first day of work to December 30th, 31st, whatever. I'm pretty sure the number was like 2,360 something. But also, keep in mind, my first shift was like one of the last days of October. So technically, that was my pay for November and December. And I missed out so many weeks because of the COVID issue and blah, blah, blah. So yes, that's just an estimate of kind of how much I made within that first little time before January hit. And then obviously January to this coming January will be like the full year. But I can't really give you a number for that because it's only September. We're not even close to January, so it won't be very accurate. But one of the questions that someone asked me from my Instagram story that I posted the other day was, when did you start to notice your income becoming more stable and consistent? And I really love this question just because of the words that she used, stable and consistent. So just to let you guys know, as a hairstylist, especially your first year, you're not really gonna have consistent income. The numbers are always gonna be different every single week. Sometimes you're gonna have a freaking amazing week, sometimes you're gonna have not so good of a week, and sometimes you're gonna have like an average week. But you're never truly going to have like a consistent pay. But I do like the word stable that she used, and I want to say my stable income started in about June, so that would be like 8 months into working. Obviously, don't get me wrong, I was making decent money before that, but like June was really when it started getting stable and good, I guess you could say. And ever since June, I've been making pretty stable and somewhat consistent pay. And a lot of the reason is also because of weddings. If your salon offers wedding hair, wedding makeup, 100% sign up for it, especially as a first year stylist, because you're still trying to build your clientele. So it's not like your weeks are going to be packed like months on end. So weddings are just amazing. They are such good money, especially because for our salon, we have to travel. So we get a travel fee. Each updo is like $125. The bride is like $225. Then you get tipped 20% gratuity for each one. It's just amazing. And wedding season this year was crazy because of COVID. Last year, everything getting canceled. So this year we were catching up and it was, oh my God, so busy, but such good money. So definitely consider doing that if you're offered it. But yes, I hope I covered everything about income. If you have any other questions, comment down below. But now I want to kind of move in to clients, growing your clients, client experience. So one of the questions was, how long did it take you to get clients that come to you when they need to? So basically, I feel like the clients that need to come to you the most frequently are gray coverage clients. And I want to say I probably have about 10 to 15 of them that come on like a 4 week, 5 week, 6 week basis to get their roots touched up. And that's going to be a really good way of having more of like a consistent schedule, consistent pay, or having those people coming in every 4, 5, 6 weeks. But I feel like most of my clientele are the high school, college, you know, that type of age group. So I don't have a ton of gray coverage clients, but one of the best things to do is if you have like high school, college clients, be like, where do your moms go? Your moms should come see me. Give them your card. They give their card to their mom, and then their moms will come to me. That's pretty much where I get like all of my gray coverage clients, so definitely learned that. But I feel like it probably took me about 8 months to find like a steady amount of people that come when they need to, as far as like gray coverage goes. But for everything else, I mainly do like lived-in balayages and stuff like that, so they don't have to come as frequently. But yeah, I wanna say about like 8 months. Another question that kind of goes along with it is, how do you keep your regulars and consistent client flow? So again, my regulars tend to be haircuts, blow dries, gray coverage clients, and like my really solid blondes, or just blondes in general that like to keep it maintained, or just blondes that are high maintenance. And honestly, the best way to keep them and have consistent client flow is to just rebook. Like, even if they're like, oh, I don't know, just do it. Just be, oh, I'll just book this appointment for you. Worst case scenario, you can cancel it ahead of time if something comes up, but literally just book them. Just book it. Especially the gray coverage clients, be like, okay, so your grays are gonna be popping in about 4 to 5 weeks, so you wanna do 4 or 5 weeks, and usually they're like 5, because they don't wanna come as often. They're like, 5 weeks? Okay, perfect. Let me put the same day. Is this time okay? And usually they're like, yeah, that's fine. I'm like, okay, perfect. So honestly, just book them. And if they're really like, no, 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 like, I'll just do it myself, then don't nag them, but really try to pre-book their next one. Another question is worst/best client experience. So I guess my worst client experience was having like my first complaint. I've really only had one client complaint, so to me it was like a very big deal, because I don't know, it was my first one and my only one so far, so it kind of made me upset. But it was just a highlight. She had a ton of hair, and I think I just didn't have enough time booked for her to do what she wanted, so I highlighted her hair. It came out so pretty, but she just wanted to be more blonde. But unfortunately, just with the time she was booked for and how much hair she had, it just wasn't gonna happen. So she had to come again to get more highlights. So I did more highlights, and she still was iffy about it. So it just made me very discouraged. But after like a week, I was like, it's fine. So that was probably the worst experience. My best experience was probably when one of my clients was like crying because she loved her hair so much. It was literally the cutest thing ever. And honestly, just like all of the clients' reactions, like when they have a truly good reaction, it's always like the best experience. And then the last thing I wanted to talk about clients and growing your clientele, and also something that I've learned throughout this year, is how important social media is for growing your clientele, especially for someone like myself, because I gravitate towards the high school, college kids, and my salon is actually right near a college. So I get a ton of those college kids, but they're all on Instagram. Like all the high schoolers, all the college kids, even like 30-year-olds, they're all on Instagram. So to be consistent on social media, especially Instagram, just posting your work, posting on your story when you have availability, if you have a last minute cancellation, like that is truly the main way I built my clientele, especially just following your clients on Instagram. That way when you post them, you can tag them, they can repost it to their Instagram, and then everyone that they follow will see it, and their friends will be like, oh my god, I love your hair, I want to get my hair done, where did you go? And then they come to me. So it's just more and more people coming to me because my client reposted my picture. But yeah, that's like one of the main things I've learned this year, is that social media is just so important in this industry. So now I kind of just want to answer the rest of the questions that you guys had put on my Instagram. This one says, what did you find the most challenging your first year? I feel like managing my time was the most challenging. Honestly, it kind of still is. Not so much managing, but just getting quicker at what I do. Honestly, it's mainly just for highlights. As far as like haircuts, colors, blow dries, stuff like that, I can do very quickly. But when it comes to highlighting, I like to be very precise. I like to lay everything out perfectly. I like to glaze the hair, root melt the hair, root tap the hair. Like, I just want it to be perfect. I want to put out amazing work, especially as a first-time artist. Like, I want people to look at my work and be like, oh my god, this is amazing. So I just like to put time into it. But I think the most challenging thing is, like, I need to just manage my time more wisely, figure out other placements to be a little bit quicker so that I can get more highlights in. Because typically, depending on what my clients are getting, I could probably only do 2, like, full highlights and haircuts a day. Maybe 3 if they're all getting partials. But yeah. Definitely timing. Next one is, what lessons have you learned in the past year as a stylist? I think the biggest lesson that I learned is to not always say yes or not always promise your clients something. I think it's a lot of, like, the box color clients that I do. Let's just say that as an example. For some reason, I get so many box colored clients. Again, it's just the age group I gravitate to. They like to do their own hair, which I get, especially during quarantine. But I feel like a lesson that I've learned is that sometimes I just need to say no. I can't always just be like, oh yeah, yeah, I promise, it'll be good. Like, yeah, yeah. Because sometimes it's not always yes, yes, yes. Because box dye is very damaging. The hair doesn't mix well with lightener when it has box color on it. So it does cause damage. Then we have to cut off the damage. And then it's just like a big process. Thankfully, I've never had a major issue with clients with box dye or like them complaining. But there has been incidences where there's been like a little bit of damage, so we had to cut a little bit off. Where literally all I had to do was say no. That's all I needed to do. But instead, I said yes because that's just me. So that's definitely one of like the biggest lessons I've learned is to just say no. Just say no. Do you use all the techniques you learn at college / your course, or do you adapt and do things differently? So Tony and Guy has a very strict way of how they section the hair, they apply the product, and so on and so on. I definitely use somewhat of the technique that they gave me, but I also have learned so much more out of hair school than I do now. Like, we never learned TZ lights, we never learned foliage, we learned a little bit of hand painting balayage, but not really like the greatest technique ever. So especially for lived in balayages, foliages, I do my own technique, or just like anything I've seen off of YouTube. I take a lot of inspo from YouTube videos. But as far as like root coverage applications, one length haircuts, I do the techniques Tony and Guy taught me. But other than that, not really. Aw, this one's cute. What's your favorite part of the workday? My favorite part of the workday is probably seeing my client's expression when I turn them around and they look in the mirror. I mentioned this earlier, but it really just is the best when you put all this hard work and time into your client's hair and they absolutely love it and they have a great reaction when they see it. And also taking pictures afterwards is like my favorite part. Do you feel confident after 1 year? I'm almost 1 month in and still learning so much. Well, congrats on your 1 month coming up. Honestly though, I do feel really confident after this 1 year. I feel like I've learned so much, I've gained so much more knowledge, and I've just matured a lot more. So I feel like I've become more confident with my clients, like talking to them, consulting with them. I've become more confident with the work that I put out. So yes, my answer is yes. Is it what you expected? Yes and no. I definitely wasn't expecting a lot of the body pains that I would have. Like, my back hurts a lot, but that's my own fault because I wear terrible shoes. I've been getting better at wearing like my Dr. Scholl's. More of like sneaker vibes and stuff like that, but definitely lots of back pain. Thankfully, no wrist or hand yet. Crossing my fingers that doesn't happen, but I wasn't expecting it to be that harsh. I also wasn't expecting for it to just be so freeing. I know that sounds weird, but I expected myself to be a lot more anxious and a lot more on my toes. But honestly, this job is just so freeing because I love it. Like, I'm just doing something that I genuinely love, and it's the best feeling ever. I did expect the summer to be really busy. I did expect to, you know, start out slow and slowly gain my clientele. I expected that. So, like, yes and no, but for the most part, yes, it is definitely what I expected. And the last question is, any new news in your life as a stylist? So I'm thinking the new news, I guess we can say, is that I'm hoping to be renting my chair within the next couple months. How my salon works is we can't rent until we've been a stylist for a year. So obviously it's been a year, but I think I'm just gonna wait it out a little bit just in case, you know, COVID, something happens again, because I know the winter, they're saying it's not gonna be as lenient as the summer was. So I think I'm just gonna wait that out a little bit. But yeah, I really wanna rent my chair very soon. Once I do, I'm gonna do a ton of videos on like preparing to rent, buying my own supplies and stuff like that. But yeah, that's the newest news I guess I could give you guys. But yeah, this first year has been amazing. It's been one hell of a year, let me tell you that. But my coworkers, my boss, the salon, it's just been amazing. We've all worked together as a big team to make everything work, and it's just been such an amazing year. But I hope I answered all of your guys' questions. If you have anything else you want to know, feel free to comment down below and I will answer them for you guys. But I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys!